Now, a suspected Pakistani terrorist has been killed by security forces in Kathua district of Jammu and Kashmir. This after the terrorists attacked a village near the international borders on Tuesday, injuring a civilian. Additional Director General of Police Jammu Zone is in Kathua to supervise the anti-terrorist operation. The top cop says the terrorist had asked for water from a household and the frightened people immediately informed the police, and a team headed by the subdivisional police officer and station house officer were rushed to the village. As per the ADGP, one of the terrorists had tried hurling a grenade and was killed in the exchange of fire. The police said that the second terrorist is still hiding in the village. Search operations are on to nab him.
The terrorists had asked for water from a household. The scared people informed the police. As soon as the information was received, the teams of SHO and SDO reached the spot. One of the terrorists tried hurling a grenade. He was killed in the crossfire. The second terrorist is in hiding. The search operation is on to find him.
Now, one CRPF personnel who was wounded in the attack later succumbed to injuries in a hospital. Meanwhile, security forces have recovered a large cache of arms and ammunition from the area, including magazines containing 90 rounds, one magazine containing 24, three live hand grenades and currency notes worth 1 lakh rupees. Terrorists also attacked an army base in Chatargala Pass in Dodar district. An encounter between the terrorists and the security forces continues in the region. 5 soldiers and a special police officer have been injured in the exchange of fire.
An exchange of fire is ongoing between the Indian Army and the terrorists in the Chatargala area.
The latest attacks come 2 days after terrorists ambushed a bus carrying pilgrims from the Shivkori temple to Kathua. As a result, the bus veered off the road, fell into a gorge, resulting in the death of 9 and injuries of 41 others. All right, to now get an understanding of what's happening on ground right now, we're joined by a senior correspondent, Idris Sloan from Srinagar. Thank you so much for joining us, Idris. What can you tell us? What's the situation on ground right now?
Well, 3 major militant attacks in the last 72 hours in the Jammu region. We are getting reports at the moment that there has been fresh firing at the Hiranagar operation site, where the DIG level as well as the SSP of Jammu and Kashmir police both were present, and militants fired on them. They escaped unhurt, but it was a narrow escape for them. On the other hand, we've been seeing 2 more operations that are being carried out by security forces in the Doda area, where last night we saw that militants fired on security forces, which resulted in the injury of 6 security personnel in that area. Security forces believe that there are around 2 to 3 militants who are freshly infiltrated from across the border in that area, and they are holed up. Security forces trying their best to nab all the attackers. However, because it's a dense forest, that's one of the reasons that security forces are finding it a little difficult to nab the attackers as soon as possible. The third and the main attack, which took place on Sunday evening in the Riyasi, we've seen that in that attack also the massive search operation still continues in the area. There are 11 security personnel teams that are on the ground looking for the militants who belong to the Lashkar-e-Taiba militant outfit. So it seems like Jammu has been an active hotbed of the militants as of now. From the last many months, we have seen that the number of attacks that have increased in Jammu region shows that there are especially foreign militants present in the region. The Jammu and Kashmir police's DGP had also recently said that in Jammu and Kashmir there are around 70 to 80 foreign militants active right now, and most of them seem to be active in the Rajouri Poonch belt. And it seems that it will be their concern, because the Amarnath Yatra is commencing on 29th of June, and security personnel already on alert, but a major concern for them would be the national highway connecting Jammu to both the base camps of the Amarnath Yatra.
Right. In fact, Idris, I also wanted to discuss, now this can essentially be perceived as the first challenge for the new government, of course. And as you mentioned as well, that most of these have concentrated areas. You mentioned the Rajouri and Poonch belt as well. Now, an attack in a place like Kathua, that is not something that we hear of very often, which essentially would imply that they have infiltrated deeper into the territory here. Now, how do you explain this?
Well, we've seen the shift of the militants in the last few months, especially in the last couple of years, from the Kashmir division towards Jammu division. We've seen that most of the infiltration that are taking place now are not from North Kashmir, but on the international border, as well as the line of control which connects to Kathua, Poonch, Rajouri belt. And especially if we talk about these fully trained militants who are coming from across the border, they're basically able to carry out these attacks and ambushes in these areas. And because of the dense forest that connects all the regions, especially the Poonch Rajouri region, it becomes extremely easy for them to escape after carrying out these attacks. And that's one of the reasons that we've seen the increase. But now, the major concern for the government of Jammu and Kashmir, as well as the security forces that are active in the Union Territory, would be to stop this. Because earlier, what used to happen is they used to basically infiltrate from Jammu's international border and then come from Peer Ki Gali range towards South Kashmir. But in the recent time, we have not seen that happening at all. Jammu and Kashmir police has also said that most of the active foreign militants now are basically based out of these Rajouri Poonch belt, which is mostly the dense forest. So that is a concern that security forces have to deal with, especially with the upcoming Amarnath Yatra, which also crosses through the Jammu-Srinagar National Highway. And we've seen in the past, not only once, but many times, Amarnath Yatra has been made. There have been multiple attacks on the Amarnath Yatra pilgrims in the past also, which this time would also be a big concern. There was a meeting that was led by Jammu and Kashmir's Lieutenant Governor yesterday of the Unified Command, which was attended by the top officials of the Indian Army, Jammu and Kashmir Police, CRPF and BSF. And the roadmap for how to carry the Amarnath Yatra peacefully was also discussed in the meeting.
All right. Well, Idris, thank you so much for getting us the latest on this. We'll, of course, continue to track all of the developments with you there. For latest news, download the VEON app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.